All right, guys, today we're going to take a look at something fairly familiar. A few months ago, we took a look at the Foxwell NT809, but that was a corded scan tool. Today, we're going to look at the NT809BT, which stands for Bluetooth, and this is a cordless OBD2 scan tool. Pretty much exactly the same as the other version, except this one's cordless. This is how it comes with a sleeve on the case. Get this sleeve off of here. The previous model came in a kind of a hard canvas case with a zipper. This one comes in a plastic blow mold case with latches. And let's get this open and we'll take a look and see what's inside here. So inside the case comes with an owner's manual and a quick start guide. Comes with a charging cord, and you can also plug the charging cord into the back of this OBD2 dongle in case for whatever reason you have a problem with your Bluetooth connectivity. You can connect the cord from here to the scan tool and it will become a corded scan tool. You also use this cord for charging, like I said, and it does not come with a power brick. I mentioned that with the other NT809. It did not come with a power brick, so I guess that's the way things are going nowadays. But then you got the scan tool itself, and looks just like the other one. See, it's upside down. Looks just like the other one, except it doesn't have a connection for the data cable. You do have a power button, USB-C port for charging, and a USB-A port if you want to use that for transferring files or if you want to plug in your VCI. And then on the back, there is no camera. But there is a kickstand, which is always necessary. And we'll get this turned on. I'll get it connected to the truck, and we'll give it a try. Okay, I've got it all plugged in. Before we take a look at the scan tool, I'll put this up on the screen so you can see it better while I go over it. I had a couple of questions and answers for the people at Foxwell, and you can read along with me here. I asked them, how long is the manufacturer's warranty? They said it's 1 year manufacturer warranty. How long is the free update period? It's 1.5 years of free updates from the day the tool is activated. How much will the updates cost after the free period ends? For 1 year, it's $160. For 2 years, it's $280. And for 3 years, it's $400. I asked, does the scan tool remain completely functional at its current software level if future updates are not purchased? And they said, yes, the NT809 will remain completely functional at its current software level if future updates are not purchased. I said, do you have a Foxwell customer service or tech support email address where customers can send tech questions if they have any problems? They said, yes, the Foxwell customer service email is support@foxwelltech.com. They said, if you have any tech questions, you can feel free to send them an email or contact us at Amazon via the email question and answer section. And then as far as tech specs, has a 7-inch diagonal daylight readable color LCD screen. It has Android 9.0 operating system. It has a quad-core 1.3 gigahertz processor. It has 1 gig of memory. It has 32 gigs of SSD hard drive storage. The communication interface, it has built-in Wi-Fi 802.11 BGN wireless. It has USB 2.0 on the go, and it has a standard USB 2.0 host. It has the Bluetooth specification. Basically, it's 4.0 Bluetooth. It has a 4,000 milliamp hour lithium polymer battery, and you can see all the protocols that it is capable of communicating with. So that's that. Let's get into the scan tool here. So, of course, just like the other NT809, and I will put that video, link to that video down below if you want to see how that one works if I miss something in this video. This one's just going to be kind of a quick overview of the scan tool since I've already done an in-depth one in the previous video. So we can go into the diagnostic here, and you can look up vehicles by either all the vehicles the scan tool is capable of, or you can look up by region of manufacturer. For this one, we're sitting in a American-made GM. And we'll do smart VIN. It'll look up, it'll pull the VIN itself instead of having to manually enter. Automatic transfer case, yes. Four button selectable. Dual zone manual. Has up level radio. Under 8600. Rear drum brakes. That's the truck. Yes. And here you can either do the quick scan where it'll go in and scan each individual module within the vehicle and pull all the trouble codes and let you see the trouble codes and a rough description of each code if there is any. Otherwise, you can go into each individual control module here. And when you go into each one of these modules, you can see live data, trouble codes, clear trouble codes, any special actuation tests, any bidirectional control. So for example, we'll go into powertrain here. So you can either read trouble codes, you can read freeze frame data from when a trouble code was set. You can look at the ECU information, you can view live data, and you can view active tests, which is your two-way bidirectional control. Let's look at that first. So we went into active tests, go into engine, and these are all the things that you can control within the engine module on this vehicle. You know, again, whatever vehicle you plug into, that can populate a different list. It all is dependent on whatever you're plugged into. So I know I've gone over that in my previous videos. I don't want to beat that to death too much, but you know, it's not just the scan tool that needs to have the capability of running certain tests. The vehicle also has to have that functionality programmed into it from the factory. You can't command something from here that the car doesn't know what to do with once it receives the command. It both ends have to be capable of doing a certain test or a certain function before it will work. We can go into fan relays. We can either turn on fan relay 1, fan 2 and 3, or fan 1, 2 and 3. And so just for fun here, let's try this one. And maybe you can hear that in the background once I get that all three fans to kick on. I'll click the on button. And hopefully you can hear all three fans running in the background. I'll turn them back off. And they shut off. We'll go back. And we got transmission. These are all the things we can control within the transmission. We got torque converter, clutch control solenoid, all the different solenoids. You can shift the transmission, pressure control solenoid, all the stuff you can control from the scan tool. We can check out live data. We can see engine live data, transmission live data. So for example, let's look at engine live data 2. This one has two full pages of live data instead of one long page. So it'll pull that data up. And then once this pops up, these are all the data PIDs that we can look at within this page. So for example, let's look at throttle position, actuator pedal position. Let's just look at that for fun. We'll select it and then hit OK. And then that'll pull it up. And right now it's in text version. And so it says it's at 0%, but if I hit the gas pedal, you can see that changes. Or we can hit the graph button and we can graph that. And then if I let off, it should drop back down. And you can record these and save these. And you can view this stuff back later. We'll go out of here. And we'll go all the way back out to the module list. And for another example, we can go into anti-lock brake system. This is where you would see like wheel speed data. And on a lot of modern vehicles, if you have a problem with your anti-lock brakes or if you have a problem with stability control or some other system that relies on wheel speed data for it to function correctly, if you've got a bad wheel speed sensor, here is where you would see that. And you could look at live data here. And so for that example, you can look at the three different wheel speed sensors on this vehicle. We've got a left front, a right front, and then rear wheel. Now, on this vehicle, as low as it goes is 3.107 miles an hour. I don't know why it doesn't go down to zero, but anyway, the point is, if you're driving straight and you're driving down the road monitoring this live data going straight, all three of these should be reading the same speed. If one of them's not, then that's the wheel that you've got a problem with your wheel speed sensor. On this particular truck, there's only one rear wheel speed for the rear axle. You know, of course, on more modern vehicles, you'd probably have a wheel speed sensor on all four wheels. And then, of course, you can go into active tests, and here's where you would get your dump valves and your ABS bleed, and like that would be the ABS bleed there. But we're going to cancel out of that. We don't need to do it. And of course, we can do a quick scan. Like I said before, this takes a little while to read through all the modules. I will speed this up so it goes quicker on video. Okay, so it's done scanning here. You can see most of the modules are fine, and this truck's got some problem with the speakers, and it's also got some communication errors in the powertrain because of a perpetual dead battery issue with this truck. I don't drive it very often. Got to dig into that. It's just not at the top of my list right now. Anyway, you can hit this down arrow and it will expand all of the trouble code list for each module, or you can collapse it again. But the first thing I like to do is save it, and then it will save all of this information, the VIN number and all that. We'll just go save, and then I'll show you later where you can find that. Then you can also click, instead of expanding each individual section like that, you can click report. And it will give you, if you scroll down, it gives you a full report of all of the codes and all of the modules. But that's the quick scan. Or we can go into the control modules like we already did. But let's go back to the main page here, the home screen. So that was obviously, we were in the diagnostic portion of the scan tool. We can go into maintenance. Now maintenance here, this is like a terminology thing. Some scan tool manufacturers call this the maintenance features. Some call it service functions. Some call it special functions. It's just whatever they want to call them. All it is shortcuts to functions that are most commonly used. Now, again, like I said before, not every one of these is going to work on every vehicle you've ever plugged into. Okay, the vehicle has to be capable of it first, and the scan tool has to be capable of functions before it will work. You know, like I've said in other videos, you know, I don't have a DPF filter in this truck. I don't have an electric parking brake in this truck. So obviously, you know, for example, those features aren't going to work. And also, just to be clear, typically these features and functions can also be found in the diagnostic menu structure, but these are just shortcuts, okay? This is just a quick shortcut to these functions that you may need on a regular basis. Then over here we have the update. This is where you would go and get your one-touch updates. We don't have any Wi-Fi at the moment. None of these are mine. But if we had Wi-Fi, that's where you would go and get all the updates, all the vehicle software, and all the firmware updates for the scan tool itself can typically be found there. So data manager, here's where you would go to find like pictures and PDF files and anything that's stored on your tablet. If we go into report, that's where I saved the report for that quick scan that I just did. That's where you'd find that. Go back here. My account, if you had a Wi-Fi connection, this would take you to your online account within the Foxwell's system. Settings, here's where you have the settings for the entire scan tool, for the tablet itself and the scan tool software. You know, you've got your unit and your language and your font size and system settings, display settings, all that. It can all be found in here. Your print settings if you want to do some wireless printing from here. We got one more page. You've got remote control. This is where somebody from Foxwell could remote themselves into your scan tool and help you with any trouble that you may be having with any situation. Firmware update. You click on here, it will list any firmware updates that may be available. The VCI manager, that's the wireless dongle that plugs into your OBD2 port. Here's where you would bind and unbind, you know, the dongle itself. Set up your Bluetooth. Auxiliary tools. This one just shows it's got a file browser. So this would be like going straight in and looking at all the individual raw files and folders within the scan tool's entire storage. And of course, coverage lists. Again, if you had Wi-Fi, this would take you to Foxwell's website, and on there they have a locator, if you will, where you can look up this particular scan tool model, and then you can also look up an individual make and model of vehicle, and it will tell you all the features that this scan tool has with that make and model of vehicle. It's a pretty nice scan tool. I like the graphical user interface. It's a nice layout, very clean looking, very simple. It's a very capable scan tool. I would say if you're in the market for a reasonably priced scan tool with above average features and functions, definitely put this one on your list of considerations. It's pretty good. That's all I have for now. Please be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.